Hi, it's Corrine for Knitwick Collections, and today I have such a fun mini album to share with you today. I am using two different collections from Knitwick Collections. One is called Jungle Fun, and the other is Hula Bazoo. I love the names. And I'll link all the information for Knitwick Collections down in the description box. And Knitwick Collections is a digital paper pack, different paper collection. So if you've never used digital before, check the description box. I have a video where I show how I use digital in scrapbooking. You can use it in the typical digital way, keeping it all on the computer, or you can print the papers and all the different elements out and use them in your scrapbooks, mini albums, your smashbook pages, or regular cards, whatever you want to do. It's limitless what you can do. Once you purchase a digital collection, it is yours to keep forever. You can print it out as many times as you want. You don't need to use a Cameo or a Cricut. I use my Cameo with mine because it makes it a little bit easier sometimes. You can simply fussy cut them out. You don't even need a printer if you don't have a printer. You can have the paper sent to a copy store and they can print them out for you. So there's lots of things you can do with digital. So if you have any questions, let me know on that, but check out the description box for more information and I'll link you to the two different paper packs that I use. So this album is 6¼ by 6 and it's a little bit different how I did this album, which I'll explain more in a moment. I did use Kathy Orta's Hidden Hinge System for the binding. The front of the cover, I used the digital paper collection and I sprayed it with this clear acrylic sealer by Mod Podge, or you can brush Mod Podge on. You don't have to, it just helps to seal it. And I was pretty happy with this. I used a coupon and got this from Michaels. So you just take it outside, spray it a few times, and it puts a clear coat over it. The actual little elements I did brush with Mod Podge and I did several layers of them. I do have a start to finish on this album. For those of you that want to stay tuned for that, I'll play that here in a moment. For those of you that don't like watching process videos, I'm doing a flip through of this album right now. So all of these elements came in the collection pack. This little guy, he's so cute, the giraffe. I added this, this is a Recollections key lock, I should say. I added that on there, just glued it behind this little pole or the gate. I have the Please Don't Feed the Animals. I think this is so cute. And I edged absolutely everything in Vintage Photo Distress Ink, Fossilized Amber, Crushed Olive, or Broken China. And I did also use a little bit of black soot around the front and back cover. Here's the back cover. My spine is 2½. I use this trim. This is, I believe, Recollections, whatever Hobby Lobby's brand is. I'm drawing a blank. The Staples collection, I believe it is. So for my pages, I used a journaling pocket that I cut from the Cameo. In my start to finish, if you don't have a Cameo, I show you how you can cut out a pocket identical to this. So every pocket is a journaling pocket, and I'll put the link of the file that I used from Silhouette America. Like I said, check out the start to finish. If you don't own a Cameo and you don't have this file, you can cut these by hand as well. On the front, I used four of these little elements that come in the collection. I added some buttons on these two. I added some twine. I backed them on black cardstock. So here is perfect for a 2½ square photo. Again, everything's blacked with black cardstock. So to the pocket, every single one has a pull-out mat. And this is a large mat. This is 5½ by 5¼. So this album will hold lots of photos. And you can place a photo or journaling on the front and back. Photos can also slide in this pocket as well. And then I did add a few graphic 45 Staples tags to them. I added three, and I had added some ribbon trim that I had in my stash that went well with the collection. So then I left, when I glued these back to back, I left the top open for another tag pocket, and I'll add the Silhouette cut. This is a tag cut from the Silhouette. I'll add that in the description box as well. So every single one has a pull-out mat. And then On some of them, like I said, I added some photo mats so more photos can be placed on the front and back of the pages as well. On this is left open so a tag or the photo can slide right under this tag. It says Monkey Business. You saw the back of this tag. To this pocket, I have a plain color paper along with the paint chip that goes with one of the collections. This one says Walk on the Wild Side. Again, I'm using two different collections. It's one main collection, but then there's two of the FQBs. One is Hula Bazoo and one is Jungle Fun. So I'm using both in this. Look on this side, this is so cute. I did a frame that comes in the collection, added my little characters, my little palm tree and the bird. Call of the Wild, that's a label that comes in it. Here is the pullout mat. And here's the tag. So lots of room for photos. On this side, I use this adorable lion. I left him open so two little photos can be placed. 2x2 photos would be perfect for this. And then, of course, your larger photo inside of this mat. Everything's black on the back side. I didn't want to add pattern paper to that because I was worried it would get too thick once the photos were added. So I only matted it with one piece of paper that shows through at the top of the pocket. I love this guy. I have his little parrot on top. I have two little photo mats that holds behind him. And this is some ribbon trim that I had in my stash. I thought it went well with the collection. This is just a plain blue mat. Here's the mat for this and the next side. This album was so fun to do. Again, another 2x2 photo. I added some of the flowers. This is left open so the photo can slide behind it. Here is the cheetah print. On this side, the vines are left open so the photo can slide, and so is this part of the directional thing. I can't think today, I'm sorry. Here is the pull-out mat. This is so cute. Lots of papers to choose from in this collection. They also include some leaves and vines. I didn't use any in this. This is some twine left open so the photo can slide behind it. Another photo mat here. The mat and then the other paint chip from the other collection. It's a zoo out there, it says. I love these paint chips. Great to add dates to journaling or just leave for decoration. I have my little bear here left open. Another label that's left open so the photo can slide behind it. Another mat. Here's the tag at the top. All of these that I left as pockets, I've doubled them. That way they're sturdy. I have this little guy behind the fence and the bird. Here's my mat. This one here has also been left open so the photo can slide behind it. Here's another Graphic 45 Staples tag. It's more of that same ribbon. And then here's my last tag at the top. And on my last page, I have another place for a little 2x2 photo. Here is the mat. And these come in the collection. They're little round. They remind me of like what flare badges should be. I had some of those sticky round clear circles in the 1-inch, so I added them to the top of that to make them like flare buttons almost. There you go. And on my last page, this is left open. This is actually a mat that pulls out so it can be used for journaling or another photo, but he can slide right behind the giraffe and the tree. And that's all there was to it. If you have any questions, please leave me a comment. Check out Knitwit Collections for all their fun products. They have tons of collections to choose from. And if you have any questions, please leave me a comment. Thanks so much for watching, and here's the start to finish. So for each of my pages, I'm using a journal pocket card that I cut from the Cameo, and I'll be sure to put a link in the description box along with the size that I cut mine out to. Here is one that is not completed, not glued together yet. It does come with score lines in it. However, I prefer to make my own score lines. So I've already scored it using my scoreboard along with my stylus. And now I'm just going to put one together quickly on camera. You want to fold into the bump that you make. One side is an indention, and then it causes this bump. You want to fold into that bump. It'll give you a better crease without cracking your paper. So really fold that down on the score lines. I'm also going to show you quickly how to make one of these if you don't have a Cameo or you don't have this exact cut. You can still make one your own. It's very simple. The only reason, and I've made them before in the past, the only reason I didn't this time is just for time's sake. It's much quicker to do it on the Cameo for me than to cut them all by hand. I just let it cut it out for me. So I'm going to add my glue. I like to make sure I get down in the corner, that it's glued down very well. I'm using Scotch Quick Dry. So here is my pocket. I've already made 6 pockets, put them together. Excuse me, I made 12 because I'm going to have 6 pages and I'm going to be backing them to each other. So I cut out 12 of them. They're already made. And if you don't have a Cameo, here is how you do it. And you want to cut it by hand. Cut a piece of cardstock to 10x8. We are going to be scoring it at 1 inch on this side, 1 inch on this side. Okay, so if we have our scoreboard, after your paper is already cut to 10x8, put it in on the 8-inch side, score it at 1 inch and at 7 inches. Then you want to go ahead and turn it 90 degrees to the 10-inch side and score it at 5.5. Okay, now where I have these little tick marks, we don't need those, so we're going to cut those out. And as it says here, we're going to notch here and we're going to notch at the top here. So I'm going to quickly do that. This may not be perfect, but I'm just quickly going to do that. So I'm cutting along that 1-inch score line up to the 5.5-inch score line, 5.5 from this side. And now here's where we want to notch it out. We're going to cut a little diagonal triangle there. Do the same on this side. And this is what we end up with. Okay, now we want to go ahead and notch these top pieces off as well. And now here's what we have. And now we're going to crease on those score marks. I'm going to crease it this way so it hides all my writing for you to see. And I'm going to crease it this way. So I'm going again. This is not how I would normally crease it, but again, I'm trying to hide all my writing at this point just so you can see. And now we would simply glue that down and we would end up with a pocket. If you wanted to match how my pockets look, these corners are rounded. You could easily round these corners. I don't have the notches. This may be a little hard to see with black. However, I don't have the notches showing here like you do here. So if you want to get rid of those, then just simply cut this down a little bit more. So you could cut down a couple, however far you want, as long as it's hidden when you glue it down. So say I took about 2 inches off, I'm going to notch it Sorry, I'm doing a quick job here, so it's not going to be perfect. So you could notch that down like that, glue it up. Now you won't see these pieces here, and then you can simply round the corners and you will end up with a pocket like mine. You can also add a half circle to it if you wanted to as well. Just by, before gluing it down, mark where the middle is, use your circle punch, insert it maybe a quarter of an inch, whatever you want, a half of an inch, whatever you want, and then punch that out, and you will end up with a pocket just like this if you don't have a Cameo or Cricut.